channel. So my grocery haul and meal plan is gonna be a little bit different this week because I have some stuff going on. The first thing is that I have to go to the dentist tomorrow and get some work done over here. So I got some stuff to help accommodate that because I feel like afterwards I'll be a little, you know, sensitive. So I got some stuff for soup and like milkshakes. Then I also am gonna do a pantry purge this week because we have a lot of stuff on hand. Every so often, you know, we get food that gets accumulated by, you know, I create a meal plan and then, you know, think something changes or our plans change and we don't wind up eating that, you know, that meal, for example, or we have extra of something. So every so often I like to do just a pantry purge. So I'm gonna show you what I got at the store first, and then I'm gonna show you our pantry and our fridge and our freezers just to show you what all we're gonna eat up this week. Okay, so here's everything we picked up at the store. Starting off over here, got a big box of coffee. So this comes with 96 K-cups for like $25. So this will last a really long time. And it's definitely cheaper to buy it in bulk. So I got a big box of coffee, and then we also got some soups back here. So just some classic chicken noodle soup, and then some New England clam chowder. And then Matt wanted some soups like on the go, so he got creamy tomato and then creamy broccoli, and then stuff for milkshakes. So the best combination for like seriously the best chocolate milkshakes ever is Bluebell Dutch chocolate ice cream and then Promised Land chocolate milk. If you guys, oh my goodness, I'm serious. It's like incredible. So I got that for some chocolate milkshakes. And then I saw this, which definitely piqued my interest. Philadelphia cheesecake. Like, it's not pudding. I think it's just like cheesecake filling. And then there's some cherry topping over here. It comes with two. I saw that and I was like, what is that? Need to have that. So I grabbed that. And then we also needed some eggs, so I got some eggs, and then some Hot Pockets, which I technically should have picked these up at Costco, but we were at Walmart, I saw them, and Connor's been wanting something like this just for kind of like a quick, it's not even like a lunch, he just eats all day long, so just a snack, I guess you could say. So I picked up some Hot Pockets. So again, definitely a small haul this week, but now I'll show you our pantry and our freezer and what we're gonna be eating this week. Okay, we'll start off with the pantry. So down there, I have like some goldfish. Let me get down there for you. So some goldfish down here, then some Capri Suns, like the onion ring mix that I accidentally bought because I thought they were just onion rings, and some formula. So this is just kind of like snacky type stuff. Over here is more of like the flour and sugar and chocolate chips and you know, things like that, kind of like baking. And then I have a bunch of canned goods. This tomato sauce is for the stuffed pepper casserole, which I never made. I kept putting it on the menu, and I've got to make it because the bell peppers are so good. So I've got to put that on my meal plan at some point this week. We got a bunch of Pop-Tarts back there. Matt and Connor went camping a while ago, and they bought some Pop-Tarts for their camping trip. And just, you know, they've ended up over here. So need to eat those. Have some applesauce right there. My spicy noodle bowls for lunch. Some bread. I also have some bread out in the freezer. Mayonnaise, you know, granola bars, cereal, more goldfish, some animal crackers. There's some trail mix back here. And then up here, we just have a ton of chips. So some potato chips, some of our tortilla chips that we get at Costco. Here are the Pirate's Booty, AKA Little Crunchies. I did go back and get the panko breadcrumbs. Some of you guys might have seen that in one of my Costco videos, where it was like $2.47 or something for like 10 pounds of panko breadcrumbs. So I just went ahead and got that. I did get this peanut butter on sale for like $2.46. It's a 2-pound jar. So just, again, a ton of stuff in the pantry, as you can see, that we can go through. Over here, it's just kind of like random stuff, some extra like salad dressing, macaroni and cheese, extra ketchup, things like that. I have some sodas down there, some applesauce or apple juice, I mean. We really don't drink soda that often. Matt will drink the Diet Mountain Dew. He's a big fan of that. But we just have like some regular like soda, like Coke down there. I don't know. It'll probably be here a year from now because I really just don't drink soda that much at all. But it is nice to have on hand. And then, of course, all the spices. So that's a look at the pantry. Okay, and then here is the fridge. Very full. So chocolate milk that I just showed you guys. We have some coffee creamer, some milk. I still have a thing of yogurt, some applesauce, apple juice, some salsa right there, and then we still have some grapes left over from Costco from a while ago that seems to be lasting a lot longer than I thought they would, but those are so good. And then we have some spinach, and then this is unsalted butter that I give the twins, so they really don't have butter that often, so that has lasted for quite a while. And then I also have some romaine lettuce right there, Connor's yogurt, some Capri Suns, some Mountain Dews for Matt, one solo Coke for me, again, whenever I feel the need to have some Coke. And then we have our eggs right there. And then back there is like half containers of some strawberries and blueberries. And then I guess I'll show you like our cheese drawer next. Kind of messy, but some cheese and some sandwich meat. And then we have these little guacamole cups that I get at Costco, some butter, and then this is the leftover butter, Kerrygold butter, that's the garlic and herb. It's like the tiniest amount, but it is worth keeping. Next time, whenever we have some garlic bread, just to brush that on top. Then some leftover bacon, probably like for breakfast, some shredded cheese, that's mozzarella, some mozzarella string cheese, tortillas. Back there is just some bagged cheese, like some Monterey Jack cheese, and I think like some Parmesan cheese. And then this is some shredded cheddar cheese. And then this is the cheesecake like thing or whatever it is. I don't even, it's not yogurt. I think it's just like cheesecake that I just showed you guys. And then for some produce, let's see, we have, it's kind of messy, but a whole bunch of jalapenos, some green onions, a lemon, some bell pepper, half a bell pepper, half of a red onion, some more cucumber, maybe I said that already, maybe not, some carrots, celery, more lemons. So there's that. And then down here, let's see, we have a loaf of French bread that I got at the store for chicken salad sandwiches, some hot dogs, which I need to just move those out to the freezer in the garage because I don't know when we'll have hot dogs next. Some waffles for breakfast, some ice cream. I think this is, yeah, some hamburger patties, some garlic bread, some frozen bananas and strawberries for smoothies. And then this is just some frozen ground beef. For like spaghetti and stuff. And then here are all the bagels that we get at Costco. So we just cut them in half, put them in freezer bags, and then you can pop them out and put them in the toaster and they don't like go bad or anything. Some chicken thighs, that's for the twins, which I actually need to take that out because I don't think they have any left in the fridge. Some chicken nuggets, some tater tots, and then some green beans. So that's everything inside. And then I'll take you out to the garage and show you the freezer out there. Okay, so here's the freezer out in the garage. Have a lot of stuff on hand. So we got these kolaches the other day at Costco, which I haven't tried them. They're for Connor. He really likes them, so those are awesome. We also have some bread for sandwiches, two pizzas, that's for a dinner one night, some Eggo waffles left, which we have definitely gone through those, so I'll be picking up another box at Costco soon. And then here is the ice cream for my milkshakes, and then some hamburger buns, which I don't think I have anything on the meal, no I do, hamburgers on the meal plan this week. And then these grilled chicken sandwiches we got at Costco, they're on sale for $6. We actually really like them, they're really good. It's kind of like the little White Castle burgers, that like how you heat them up in the microwave, but it's grilled chicken instead. So surprisingly really tasty if you haven't tried those yet at Costco. A bunch of ground beef left from Zacon, womp womp. A little bit of chicken left, I guess. Oh, that might be the only bag I have left. A chicken breast, and then chicken wings, which we're having that for dinner tonight, and then again sometime this week. And then over here, just have some tamales from Costco, some of my freezer mashed potatoes, and then some Hot Pockets, which I showed you earlier. And then this is some artisan bread that we use for our grilled chicken sandwiches. But that is everything out in the freezer. But that's it for this video. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.